Good afternoon, dear children. Welcome once again to another session of EVS Interactive class. In our last class, we had started a new chapter, Plant Life, in which we had done its introductory part. We had done why plants are included in living organism, they are considered as living organisms, and how plants are different from animals. Now, continuing the topic, today we will take parts of a plant. Parts of a plant. A plant is mainly divided into two parts, a root system and a shoot system. The part that grows below the ground is called root system of a plant, and the part that grows above the ground is called the shoot system of a plant. Means the part of the plant that you can see from your naked eyes, that is visible to us, is its shoot system. The root system is underground. If we talk about the structure of a plant, then we can see that there are a variety of plants around us. They all differ in some way or the other. They may differ in their root system or in their shoot system or in the arrangement of leaves. This we will see in this chapter. The roots of a plant are the lower section of the plant. Attached to the stem at its base. They are an essential part of the plant's survival, tasked with the responsibility of anchoring the plant. Means their function is to fix the plant to the ground and also takes moisture and nutrients, or absorbs moisture and nutrients to be delivered to the other parts of the plant and enable it to grow. The roots in most of the plants stay underground and are invisible part of the plant to most who view it. The roots often extend far into the ground, spreading deep and wide to ensure the plant has plenty of food and drink within its reach. Small plants such as grasses, they have shallow roots. Means their roots are not too deep in the soil. While big plants have thick and deep roots with complex root system. But there are some exceptions also. And the exceptions, like there are some plants who lack root, in which roots are not present, or if the root is present, that is not playing the primary function of supplying water and minerals to the plant. They are just for the anchoring purpose. So, exceptions are also there. So, as you will grow and go to higher classes, then you will study about these exceptions. Now, let's discuss the functions of roots. Roots perform two types of function, primary function and secondary function. Primary functions are performed by all type of roots, but secondary functions are performed by some modified roots. Primary functions of roots are, first is to fix the plant into the soil. Second is to absorb water and minerals from the soil. Third is transportation of water and minerals to the other parts of the plant. And fourth is to hold the soil together. By doing this, they prevent the washing of soil, top layer of the soil, especially by wind and water. Now, coming to secondary functions. Secondary functions are performed only by specialized roots, we can say modified roots, who perform some special functions besides the primary functions. And such roots are not present in all type of plant. They are present in only few plants. And the secondary function of roots are, number one, some roots are specialized to store food. Means they are specialized for storage of food. And second is, some roots are specialized to give mechanical support to the plant. Mechanical support by giving extra support means these plants have root, but because their branches are so heavy that they need extra support, so such type of plants or trees have adventitious roots which come from the outer part of the plant, like from branches, and they grow downwards and they give extra support to the plant. Children, look at the picture of these roots. You can see root of turnip, beetroot, sweet potato, carrot and radish. You can see their sizes are different and their colors are also different. So all these roots are edible. Edible means they can be eaten raw or in cooked form. You can notice that all these roots are swollen because these roots perform secondary function of storage of food. So they are swollen because they store food in their roots. So we can eat the root part of these vegetables. In this picture, you can see a banyan tree is there, and the roots are coming down from the branches towards the earth. So in this case, you can see that the roots are performing the secondary function of mechanical support. Because the branches of the tree are too heavy, So to give them extra support, they stand as pillars to support the heavy branches of the tree. So in this case, in this example, you can see that roots are performing the function of mechanical support. In this picture, you can see that the roots coming out from the lower side of the stem, and they are giving mechanical support to the corn plant. Similarly, in this picture, you can see the small hair-like roots coming out from the stem of ivy plant. This helps the plant to climb. In the same way, there are many other plants in which the roots that come out from the other parts of the plant, they help the plant to give the mechanical strength. Children, in our next session, we will discuss about the types of root and also about the shoot system.